Back now on the morning show, we were talking about what Oprah was talking about.
Yeah, exactly. We're again watching
Get us out of trouble. All right, suction can work in strange ways by cleaning your house, holding things in place, also creating some differences in the atmosphere.
Right.
Someone's here.
Right. So what I really wanted to talk about, since we did hurricanes last week, and we talked about low pressure and how you have the storm surge that actually raises the level of the ocean because of the pressure difference, I thought one really cool thing to do would be to show other things that result because of the very high atmospheric pressure that we actually have where we live.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't believe it's high, I have a demonstration for you, and you guys are going to help me, because what happens is you have the air pushes on all parts of our body all the time. And that pressure is actually 15 pounds per square inch. It's a rather large pressure.
Is that different in this area? Because you mentioned this area.
Oh, I mean on the surface of the Earth.
Oh, well,
okay,
this area.
As opposed to like the moon or someplace,
gravity,
I guess.
Whatever.
Right. And 15 pounds per square inch is a lot of force. To give you an idea, if I had 15 pounds per square inch on the top of my hand, but on the bottom there was no air at all, suppose there was a vacuum where there was no pressure pushing up, I would be having to support about 300 pounds with
my
hand.
Gosh.
So that's how much, and imagine how big your body is. It's much bigger than your hand, so there's tons of force pushing in on you all the time.
Okay,
and so we can illustrate this with these things. If you guys want to come around to the front, I will get this ready for you. We've done these before, but I think they're really cool. It's just two empty halves, a sphere cut in half, and I'm holding the parts together. I'm sucking a little bit of the air out of the middle of this thing, okay? And I don't even have to suck all the air out because of,
Because basically what we're doing is creating a vacuum.
We're creating a vacuum inside this thing. What that means is that we're making the pressure inside this thing lower than it is on the outside.
Okay.
So what is going to happen?
So what's
going to
happen is right now, since we're pulling some of the air out of the inside, that means that there's less... Oh, can you pick that up? It's falling apart on us. Okay? Now, if you guys start pulling... Well, I'll explain. Just pull in either direction.
It won't pull
apart? You can't pull it apart. There's 15 pounds for every square inch pushing in on this thing, but since we suck some of the air out from the inside, there's less pushing back out again.
Okay,
so if we let the air back inside, mm-hmm. then you're going to have 15 pounds per square inch on the inside, and it's going to come apart
It'll pull apart.
Right, so if you keep pulling, and if you wanted to...
Are we going to fall?
There we go.
Okay, all right, so it comes apart real easy.
Yeah.
So, in fact, you couldn't pull this thing apart, no matter how hard you tried, if I'd pulled most of the air out of this thing, because the pressure is really quite high.
Okay.
So then the question you can ask yourself is, how come this pressure doesn't crush me? Right? It's kind of a good question.
Well, yeah.
And there's a couple of reasons. First of all, your body's mostly made out of liquid, and so it's like this balloon, which I put some water in, and you can sort of squish on this thing, and you can't compress it because liquid is not compressible.
Okay.
So it's just going to give with your hand.
It's going to just, basically, you get pushed on from all sides evenly, so nothing really bad happens. If you push on all sides except for a little spot, you see how you can have this up sort of pop out? So that's equivalent to if the air was pushing all over on you, but there was one part of your body where the pressure was lower.
Uh-huh.
You would have a little bulging out like
we'd
this.
We'd have some problems.
Well, okay, so this is like a hickey. Okay, if you put your mouth on your arm and you sort of suck a little bit, you're creating a lower pressure there, and that causes the insides of your arm to kind of want to come out.
Pull out, okay.
And so the little blood vessels break, and then you get a red mark.
But that's creating a little vacuum there as
well. That's right, exactly right. So pressure differences make everything move. That's how the vacuum cleaner in your house works.
Sure.
There's a pump that removes some of the pressure, and basically the high pressure air outside rushes into the vacuum where the pressure is lower, and it takes the stuff with it. Yeah.
Okay.
So it's basically the vacuum works just like wind.
Wow. Okay. Next time you're going to talk
a lot
about
of information.
Yeah.
When we come back in about half an hour.
Yeah.
I'll show you the science behind these.
And we're going to play with a wine glass too.
Ooh. We got it all here, folks. All right, we're going to send it over. Send it over to Chris. But if you have questions about this or any of the other things that Matt does here on the show, or if you have questions for him, send them in. All right, Chris, what's going on?
I want to know if Matt actually has as much fun on the job as he has here.
Something tells me yes.
Yes, I do.
Yes, he does.
All right, well, that's a good job then.